Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. We are making videos, series of videos on technologies. Now we are making videos on web technologies. Today, if you take any website, completely depending upon web. So any web applications, all the web applications are developed with the help of web technologies. So today I am giving an introduction about web technologies. Later we will cover all the topics of web technologies. What are the topics we will cover in future will be explained in this video very clearly. So first, web technologies, it is a collection of web pages. Website is a collection of web pages, and web pages are of two types. One is static websites. Second one is dynamic website. Static websites means we cannot change, only for the purpose of reading. Dynamic websites means the data will be changed dynamically at runtime. So when we are developing web applications using static, we need to know HTML by HTML5 version, CSS means cascading style sheets by version 3, JavaScript, jQuery, Ajax, AngularJS, and Bootstrap. If you know all these things, you can develop static websites by your own. Okay, similarly, when coming to the dynamic, including static plus Java plus AnyDB, preferably Oracle or MySQL. Similarly, .NET plus AnyDB, preferably SQL Server. Similarly, PHP plus MySQL, preferably MySQL, otherwise AnyDB. Similarly, Python plus AnyDB. Like, if you take any one of the combination for developing it, but for our flexibility, we are going with PHP and MySQL in this series of videos. Now, in this video, we need to give brief introduction about HTML, cascading style sheets, also called as CSS, and JavaScript, and PHP and MySQL. So, coming to the HTML, HTML, also called as Hypertext Markup Language, was initially developed by Tim Berners-Lee starting in 1989. He was the scientist, he was the person behind the web technologies. Tim Berners-Lee proposed SGML, Standard Generalized Markup Language, out of which they implemented HTML, that is Hypertext Markup Language. HTML is a markup language for describing web documents. HTML stands for Hypertext Markup Language. A markup language is a set of markup tags, and here the markup tags are of two types. One is pair tags and non-pair tags. Non-pair tags means there is only one tag we are using it, either like this or like this. We are representing non-pair tags. If you pair tags have two things, one is starting, and again we need to put an ending with hash angle, and each and every tag is in between left angle bracket and right angle bracket. We are mentioning the name of the tag. HTML documents are described by HTML tags. Each HTML tag describes different document content. So second one, cascading style sheets. CSS stands for cascading style sheets. CSS describes how HTML elements are to be displayed on screen, paper, or in other media. CSS saves a lot of work It can control the layout of multiple web pages all at once. External style sheets are stored in CSS files. Simply, I can tell you one thing. So, if you want to design 100 web pages for a single website, but the question is, each web has different style sheets, it is difficult for us to handle. If you design one CSS file and we call the CSS file in all the pages, it gives more reliable and efficient way of utilizing the concept of CSS. So next, JavaScript. It is a programming language. It is an interpreted language. It is object-oriented programming. It is widely used and supported. It is accessible to the beginner. It is a client-side scripting. What is the meaning of client-side scripting? So client validations are done through JavaScript. Let us say a simple example. When we are logging into an email account, so first you are typing email ID, and second you are typing password, and click on log. But email ID have a specific syntax, like @ and dot. In between, we are writing something for email ID. If you are not using @ or if you are not using dot in email ID, whenever I am logging it, it checks in the database whether that is exist or not. Will take a lot of processes. Instead of ignoring this, it checks at the browser side by adding some functionality. That functionality is added with the help of JavaScript. Not only this, mobile number consists of 10 digits, but if you are entered 9 digits and we need to cross check with the database, it is wrong way. So using client validation, using JavaScript, we are writing to check whether the user enters 10 digits or not. This type of validation is done are called client-side scripting. Small size calculations, everything should be done with JavaScript. Today, JavaScript is one of the popular programming languages in the world because everything should be done with the help of JavaScript. Now, coming to the PHP and MySQL, PHP is a hypertext preprocessor. PHP stands for hypertext preprocessor. It is server-side scripting. It generates dynamic paging content. PHP can create, open, read, write, delete, and close files on the server. PHP can collect form data. PHP can send and receive cookies. PHP can add, delete, modify data in your database. PHP can use to control user access. PHP can encrypt data. Similarly, what is MySQL? MySQL is a data storage. MySQL is a database system used on the web. MySQL is a database system that runs on the server. MySQL is ideal for both small and large applications. MySQL is very fast, reliable, and easy to use. MySQL uses standard SQL. MySQL compiles on a number of platforms. MySQL is free to download and use. MySQL is developed, distributed, and supported by Oracle Corporation. MySQL is named after co-founder Monty Widenius's daughter. Okay. So here I need to tell one thing. So we are creating HTML pages. It is a process of CSS in JavaScript, and we are communicating with the server pages like PHP. After that, this PHP interacting with the database. Similarly, it responds to the server script and also respond to the displayed in the HTML page. This is the way the web applications are communicating through one by one. Thank you.